The goal of this project is to capture the knowledge and experiences of change leaders to help inform other departments and colleges in transforming the STEM programs. We interviewed 8 individuals from institutions across the country. We asked them to share advice on how to increase retention and how they improved the culture within their programs. This is what they had to say.
At Mines, we have a required advising session for all students each semester, and students attend different sections, but they all have to attend one. And one thing we did, one topic, one semester, there's always the typical advising stuff, but I always had a special topic. You know, one semester might be on the Career Center and taking advantage of their resources. One semester might be on research opportunities. Another semester was on foreign study. One semester was on culture. And we broke the students into small groups to talk about their thoughts of the culture, what they thought the culture in the department was, and how we could make the culture better. And we also had an anonymous form that students could fill out if they felt uncomfortable discussing this openly. And we just, as a community, we talked about it. What are the challenges within the department? What are we doing well? How can we do better?
What I did was I thought, well, why don't we, instead of trying to eliminate the negative aspects and focusing on them, like, why don't we try to teach people how to be and how to teach and how to be aware of these phenomenon, like psychosocial phenomenon and these biases and toxicity from the get-go. And so I created CS370, which is our pedagogy course, the one that's equity-oriented, adaptive and equity-oriented. And instead of only allowing TAs to take that course, which is mandatory, when you TA, you have to simultaneously take a teaching class. And we have those two options, the regular one and then mine. And so that class allowed people to take it as early as when they academic intern or tutor for the first time. So we even have a ton of freshmen in it. And once you take it, you don't have to take a class when you do TA. So the idea was to, for lack of better phrasing, indoctrinate the youth upon arrival in the ways of being more accessible and equitable, so that when they become TAs, you know, it'll cascade down, like grassroots up, so that it will then cascade down and catch everyone else who, you know, may not take the class.
So at Mines, about 9 years ago, I started an industry partnership program with where companies would fund student scholarship funds. And one of the goals of the partnership program is also inclusion and broadening participation in computing. And so our partners have the opportunity, if they're interested, to talk, for example, to our ACMW group. And then I made sure our scholars were, you know, we had diverse scholars. So that's part of, you know, just making sure that we are fair in the way that we evaluate students and everyone gets a good shot at a scholarship. The women at Mines do a great job, just a great job there. So they well earn their scholarships. But when I'm assigning scholars to companies, I try to think, you know, do that strategically as well.
Students are conditionally admitted into that program, and it's called the Allen School Startup Program. The program includes a 4-week summer pre-autumn course. So students come to campus 4 weeks before the quarter starts. It's a small cohort of 35 students. We're actually trying to grow that cohort, but currently it's 35. And one of the things that we really try and emphasize is community. We know that one of the biggest factors for students to be retained in our major and here at UW is if they feel like they're actually connected to people, particularly people who have their identities and experiences that they are coming into the UW with. So we really try and create that cohort, and then that group of students has a whole year with us. So they see us once a quarter with academic advising. They also have to take workshop courses. We have a lot of fun events where we take them around Seattle. And then we do cohort meetups throughout the year. So we really try and create that community.
Something we did a long time ago that has been really important is we have pods. So students come in, they're in a pod of 25. Their group of 25 takes their CS courses and their math courses together, and then meets once a week to sort of get introduced to like college, right? Like, what is college going to be like? All this kind of stuff. There's a pod mentor that is one of the students that's assigned. And that has really helped us. And many years back now, we started trying to make sure that there was any pod that had women had a critical mass of women.
One thing that I did initiate with a student is a hackathon. It's called Hacker 413. It's a wonderful hackathon. Please check it out. We usually have about 900 applicants each year. And we usually have about 300 to 400 students that participate. It has become a real supportive space for women and non-binary and other people from other genders on our campus.
What we did see very early was students were getting kind of a spotty amount of feedback. And you need to know how you're doing. It's not just students worried about their grades. They want to do well. They want to learn the material. So if they are learning and the kind of work they're doing demonstrates that they're learning, then you should tell them that. And that's the kind of work that we try and encourage our faculty members to do.